I'm Marty Hesting, and I want to come to you from Beloit, Kansas, as owner-operator of Kansas Barnwood. What I've so thrilled and enjoyed my life to do from growing up in these Kansas barns on farms, learning a good work ethic, most of it taking place right in some of these big, massive barns in Kansas as we fed livestock, took care of livestock, and most importantly, stored hay in these great big barn buildings in Kansas. Now what I've come to do in my lifetime, as they're slowly or more rapidly disappearing from the landscape, is to reclaim this beautiful, lustrous wood, pine wood, out of Colorado Rockies for the most part, and so many wonderful things to do with it. Flooring, siding, home decor, everything from picture frames to tabletops to coffee end tables. There's just a never-ending things to do with this wonderful barnwood. And the thing is that you're reclaiming part of our environment and reusing it. And we've all come to honor and protect our environment just a little bit more. In this great, great world that we have, we need to reuse and reuse things. Now, some of this wood that was out of the 20s, 30s, and 40s, all shipped across rails through Nebraska, dropped down into Kansas on outlying rails. This is where I come in. I live and I'm from Kansas. I've established a relationship with many, many of the farmers, and they too agree that the barns are not as much use anymore because of the farm growth and farm size. So reclaiming this wood is very important now. I think that you would find that this wood can be used to satisfy lots of your needs in your homes. What we have here is a foot wide vertical plank siding off of the barn. As you can see, the barn was painted red. It's weathered real nice. Barn probably in the 1930s or 1940s. Vertical siding, foot wide, various lengths. This is a short little piece, but length spanning up to 14 or 16 feet. Barnwood, what we have here today is horizontal siding off of the barn. Once again, red, nice texture. Lapped siding, where the pieces fit in, and then beveled on the front edge. This piece, particular piece, is about 9 inches wide, but lots of the barnwood would be 4 to 6. As you can see, here's your beveled edge in which the siding was put on. Kansas barnwood piece, once again, horizontal siding, put together lapped with the beveled edge inside to put together a very nice piece of wood. Probably, actually this came off of a second level hay mount floor in a barn where hay was stored. This was flooring, very good piece of wood. 2x4, 2x6, 2x8, inside barnwood, not siding, trestles to hold up the hay mount floor, trestles to hold up the roof, typically 2x4, 2x6. This is beautiful wood. You'll notice the knot, nice knot hole pines, and particularly taken out of big pine trees in Colorado back in the 20s, 30s, and 40s. 6x6 wooden beam. Very, very nice. One piece, all sided. This was actually put in and carved in by hand and not cut in hand in the particular barn that it came out of. But as you can see, it's been just ever so slightly buffed on this side to give you a full, nice, good grain. 6x6 wood beam pine. This is a particularly interesting piece of Kansas barnwood. This is actually the batten on vertical side barns that would go between the two pieces of wood to cover up the seam. It is a very unique strip of wood. Some of these were done in metal. The older ones were done in a pine strip. Very hard to find. Very hard to keep in good shape, as it is the first piece of the barn that typically deteriorates due to weathering and rain and moisture.